Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video we are going to look at how to answer some GCSE style exam questions for solving equations. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. For a refresher on solving equations, see our algebra video linked above and in the description. Let's look at this first set of questions. For question 1, we can add 4 to both sides of the equation to get rid of the minus 4, as we need to get y on its own side of the equals sign. We are left with y equals 11, which has solved the equation. For question 2, t has been divided by 4. So, we need to multiply both sides by 4, to cancel out the division and leave t on its own. For question 3 we are told that 7 lots of j equals 56, so we need to find out what 1j would equal. To do this we divide both sides by 7 so we are left with 1j. For the final part, we can add 6 to both sides of the equation. The next set of questions are slightly more difficult. The first question requires us to make more than one step to get the variable g on its own. Firstly, we can take away 8 from both sides of the equation. We are then left with an equation which tells us that 2 lots of g equals minus 5. Therefore, 1g is half of minus 5. For the second question, we need to firstly find out what 2c equals. So, we can multiply both sides by 5 to get rid of the division. We then divide by 2 to find out what 1c equals. Question 3 is a bit different. We are told if we add up 3 lots of n we get 15. So, we need to simplify then solve. If 3n equals 15, then we can divide 15 by 3 to find out what 1n equals. Question 4 also requires us to make more than one step to get d on its own. Firstly, if we take away 18 from both sides, we can see what 7 lots of d equals. Now we can divide 56 by 7 to find out what d equals. The final set of questions involves slightly more complicated calculations to solve. With question 1 there are two ways we can solve this. We can either expand the brackets or rearrange. Let's look at how we can rearrange this equation before solving. Firstly, we can remove the 5 outside of the brackets by dividing both sides by 5. We can then add 3 to each side to cancel out the minus 3 and get f on its own. For question 2, let's see how we can solve this by using the expanding brackets method. Firstly, we should multiply each term in the brackets by 4, to get rid of the brackets. We only do this to the side with the brackets. Then we can add 8 to both sides, leaving us with the equation 20w equals 56. Finally, we can divide both sides by 20. For the third question, we need to rearrange the equation to get all terms in h on one side and all the constant terms on the other side. Firstly, let's move 2h to the other side of the equals sign, remembering to change the sign from a plus to a minus. We can then move the 3 to the right side, making it a minus 3. Finally, we can simplify and solve. the final question involves a power. But firstly, we should get rid of the 5, by taking away 5 from both sides of the equation. We are then left with the equation d squared equals 25. We then take the square root of both sides to find out what d equals. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your exams.